How hard does Vanes Martirosyan hit? How hard does Vanes Martirosyan hit?
Man.
Well, let him hit you. Let me cut Joe off.
Okay, can you land one on Ricky's chin and we can see if he goes down?
We want to see he hit you, man. Come on.
I'll let him hit me in my shoulder once after this interview. He could get on camera. But Joe, how hard does he hit compared to other guys you worked with at 54?
I'm really just waiting with you.
Okay, point.
Let me tell you, number one, Vaughn, his physical stature in front of you is big. I mean, he looks really big to me because he's like my size. I'm not 154 pounds. So, that being said, he's got a huge set of mitts. That's number two. Number three, he throws the right hand about as perfectly as you can throw a straight right hand. Just comes right down the pike and it really turns well. And he's got great leverage on it and he can throw it numerous times during a fight and keep the accuracy. Now, that being said, his left hand, which is a little bit more dormant in the fights, we're working on that right now to clean that little area up. I'm going to tell you, his left hook, his left uppercut, his body, it's extremely hard. So I think once we combine both hands here and get them working in unison, or I should say at least in combination, he's going to be really frightening to have to fight. He's tall, he's fast, he's got extremely good legs to get in and out, and then bringing that power that he has, it's going to be dangerous for who's ever in front of him. I'm very, very extremely high on boxing.
Vanes, Joe has been training in boxing for 42 years. He brings his experience. How much fun do you guys have being here at this gym with Joe?
I used to come to this gym when Casamayor was training here. I was a kid. Yeah, I don't know if Joe remembers me.
Joe, do you remember him as a kid coming here when Casamayor was here?
I do.
How do you remember? You're just saying that.
A lot of our kids would come and watch him. Well, my uncle, I think, was in love with him or something. I don't know. But I used to, he's the one who would bring me here to watch him train. And I used to watch Joe. I just wish I would listen to that 10 Pro.
And if that would happen, but you're here now.
Yeah, it's better late than never, right?
No. I think, you know, things happen for a reason at certain times. And, you know, he accomplished a lot the way he, you know, did things in the past. And I can only imagine combining forces now how far we can go. I just think Vaughn has got an extremely bright future. And, you know, the guys at 154 are very popular right now, and there's a lot of publicity surrounding them, and I just think we're in the right spot at the right time.
What can you tell me about Joe Goossen, Brian?
Joe Goossen, great guy, man.
Why?
Great guy. I've been on Joe for
quite some time, man.
Joe has had my back for quite some time, man. You know, he when he needs work, calls me. You know, he's good people, man. Good people.
Have you met Samson?
Huh?
Have you met Samson yet?
Well, before you go on to the Samson, because that's a hell of a segue from me to Samson. But that being said, I appreciate what Brian just said there, because I don't think there's any better compliment than somebody just saying you're a good person. That's all I hope to be. So thank you, Brian.
Thank you. You're welcome, Joe.
Thanks for the no one.
Okay, right? Last thing, Joe. I talked to Vanes. He's ready. He's willing. He's down to fight Canelo Alvarez. Vanes told me he fights Canelo, he stops him.
Canelo's cousin right there, bro.
All right.
Hey, he's from the same town as Canelo.
Maybe they're related.
Venice? You're not from the same town, your parents, are they?
My dad is.
Yeah?
Yeah.
A lot of Irishmen up there in Mexico.
As you can see, the red hair.
Are you Mexican?
100% American.
No. He's 100% of Mexican descent. Oh. Both parents.
Vanes Canelo.
Oh. First off, listen. If Mayweather boxed him that easily, and Mayweather is half Vanes' size, of course, he's the greatest boxer on the planet right now. But if Mayweather could do that to him, and we've got the power at 54, I think we could box him and really land some hard shots. I see him stopping Canelo. I see him stopping Canelo. Okay? Look, everyone he fights, he knocks down. Look, can Canelo hurt Nora?
Not really. Just with the body, he broke him down, but he didn't drop him. No, he didn't knock him out. Yes.
Okay. But the bottom line is this. He's training differently than he has in the past. And I just think it's going to be all the difference in the world. And, you know, look, time will tell. We're looking, we're waiting for our date right now, are we not?
Well, early September.
Yeah.
That's what I was going to do.
Either September 6th or September 13th.
One of the two.
And they're both big cards. Either Broner card and Matisse in Cincinnati or Mayweather Maidana.
Yeah. We'll take it as it comes.
One question I have for Vanes. Vanes, you fight at 154. B-Hop fights at 175. How did you spar a guy 20 pounds bigger than you?
And I tried to spar himself.
And you just switch?
Yeah.
How do you do that?
Freddie wanted me to fight himself, but he was fighting Winky, right? And I was his best sparring, man. I did really well.
Do you ever switch during the fights? Not really.
I've never switched during the fights. Maybe like just a switch, just to throw the guy off for like 5 seconds and I go back. But
Joe's an expert in working with southpaws.
Yeah.
As soon as I turn southpaw, he goes, nah. Yeah.
Let's get the right-handed system down first. Perfectly.
So there you have it, Vanes Martirosyan, Joe Goossen, Brian Brooks, right here at the Goossen Jimmy Van Nuys. EsNews.com and Malisek back reporting.
Reporting.